NetHunt here, Gmail's CRM and sales automation expert. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up an email drip campaign in NetHunt for lead nurturing. This is the first part of our special workflows video series, helping you automate and boost your sales. Let's get growing. First things first, where can you find the automation feature? Well, head to your dashboard and you'll find a new button on the left navigation panel called Workflows. But what's it for? Well, that's a short question with a long answer. Let's take a look at a real use case. Let's say you need to send an email sequence when a contact status in NetHunt has changed to lead. Similarly, you might need to stop this sequence when an email has been received from the same contact, or if their status has changed to one. Here's how to do it. Step 1, create a new workflow. Go to Workflows and click the plus new button in the top right corner. Name your workflow and hit continue. Step 2, add a starting trigger. To create your workflow, hit the add starting trigger button. Then pick a trigger that will start the workflow. In this example, we chose field value changes, then chose the folder and the field. Run once per record means the current workflow will be executed once for any given record, regardless of how many times a selected field changes. Depending on the workflow type, you either check or uncheck this box. If you don't specify a change, the workflow is triggered by any change in the selected field. In our case, we need the workflow to run when there's a specific change in the status field, so we check the specify change box. We're also defining a specific change in the status field that triggers our workflow. That is, when a contact is moved from new to lead. Now, we've set up a starting trigger. We can rename it or we can delete it by checking the three dots. If you need to edit this step in any way whatsoever, just click the box itself. Moving on to step 3, which is to create a condition to stop. For contacts to leave this workflow, we need to set a condition to stop. In our example, we've got two conditions. First, if the contact has a new incoming email linked to it. And second, if the status has changed again. To create our condition, we'll split our workflow into three separate branches. First, the main one, branch A. Second, the one that checks for any incoming emails, branch B. And third, the one that checks for any changes to the status field. That's branch C. So here's what we've got so far. In branch B, we'll add an action to wait for email and click save. In branch C, we'll add an action to wait for update in the status field from lead to any value. Afterwards, this is what we get. Step 4, let's add some actions. It's time to add the actions that we've created a trigger for. We're going to use branch A for that. Click the Add Action button and pick the action type you need. We want to send emails, so obviously we pick Send an Email. In the From field, we pick who is sending the email. If, for example, you have multiple sales managers in your team and want each contact to be emailed by their own manager, check the Personalized Sender box and pick the required field. In the To field, pick the email addresses you want to send the email to. Then enter the subject and your main email text. You can use templates and insert macros if you need to. Finally, hit save. Let's also add a couple more emails in the same way for good measure. And let's add a waiting time between those emails. After all, we don't want them to be sent one right after each other. Click on the plus sign after the first email and pick wait for time. For the sake of this video, I'm going to type 1 minute to show you exactly how the automation works. After typing in 1 minute, I hit save, but you can choose any period of time you need, obviously. Step 5, complete the workflow. In order to complete the workflow, at the end of every branch, we need to add action and workflow. This is what that looks like. When we're ready, we hit activate to launch our shiny new workflow. Now you thought you were done, but step 6 is to test your automation. Let's see how it works. For the sake of the test, go to the contacts folder, select one new contact record and drag it to the lead stage. This is our trigger after all. Email should be sent automatically. The first one is sent immediately. The second and third ones are sent at 1 minute intervals. You can check the record timelines. We can now see 3 test emails in the contacts inbox. Once the workflow is active, you'll be able to edit it, view the number of actions performed at each step, view the workflow and error log, and deactivate it altogether. So, have you already tested workflows by NetHunt CRM? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to join our beautiful NetHunt CRM user community and get involved in the conversation. The link is in the description. This was part 1 of NetHunt CRM's special workflows video series. Stay tuned for the next videos where we cover web firm lead capturing, automatic email and Slack notifications, and sales workflows. As always, like, subscribe, and press the notification button to get regular, fresh NetHunt content. See ya!